day to you viewers out there. My name is Bumi Adekola, and I'm a pastor in Christ Love Assembly, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Didcot in Oxfordshire, United Kingdom. It is my privilege to present to you the Open Heavens Reflections today, based on the Open Heavens Daily Guide, written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Our topic today says the healing touch, and our Bible passage is taken from the Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 8 and the first three verses. When he had come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him, and behold, a leper came and worshipped him, saying, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." Then Jesus put out his hand and touched him, saying, "I am willing, be cleansed." Immediately his leprosy was cleansed. May everything symbolizing leprosy in your life receive the touch of Master Jesus today, in Jesus' name. Our memory verse is Matthew chapter 8, verse 3. Then Jesus put out his hand and touched him, saying, "I am willing, be cleansed." Immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Our reflections. The God of all flesh, to whom nothing is impossible, can decide to do whatever seems right to him at any point in our lives. As we maintained at the beginning of this month, because he is the God of all flesh, he specializes in the healing of his people and making bodies that have been besieged by sicknesses and diseases to receive divine healing. I pray for someone listening to this telecast today that the God who is a Jehovah Rapha will make you whole in the name of Jesus Christ. He is the Lord, our healer. God can choose any means to heal us and to make us whole. There are times when he can use a touch. In the Bible passage that we read earlier, Jesus decided to touch this man who was a leper. This can be both divine and profound. Divine, because Jesus was walking against the law that forbid people coming close to lepers. However, because he is the God of all flesh, he could come close and even touch with no adverse consequence. This gesture was also profound because of the love and compassion that Jesus had for this man, notwithstanding his situation in life. In addition to the above, God can also do the work of healing by simply sending the word to go and do the healing. In Psalm 107, verse 20, the Bible says that he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from all their destructions. This was clearly understood by the centurion in Matthew 8, verses 5 to 10. When Jesus had entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him asking for help. "Lord," he said, "my servant lieth at home, paralyzed, suffering terribly." Jesus said to him, "Shall I come and heal him?" The centurion replied, "Lord, I do not deserve to have you come under my roof, but just say the word and my servant will be healed. For I myself am a man under authority, with soldiers under me. I tell the one, go, and he goes. And that one, come, and he comes. I say to my servant, do this, and he does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, "Truly, I tell you, I have not found anyone in Israel with such a great faith." This man's faith was commended by Jesus. Will you receive and accept his transforming word for your life today as well? Receive a life-changing breakthrough today in the victorious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Take advantage of the forthcoming convention of the Redeemed Christian Church of God coming up in August this year in Nigeria. It's going to be broadcasted live all over the world. So take advantage to receive harvests of miracles for your life as you prepare for the event. We are going to pray now. Let us thank God for the success of past Holy Ghost conventions. Let us thank God for every soul that had been saved. Let us thank God for every healing that had taken place in years past. Let us thank God Almighty for healings. Let's thank God for transformation of lives. Let's thank God for restoring marriages. Let's just bless the name of the Lord God Almighty for what He had done over the years. And now we pray that this year's convention will be the greatest ever experience. Shall be so in your life and in my life. In Jesus' name, it is well with you. God bless you richly. See you very soon, and bye.